In closing this meeting, let me make three points. The first one is on the topics. The second one is on the what next. And the third and last one will be on us as a network. On the topics, what came across in all regions is a strong sense of urgency, not surprising, but a strong sense of urgency combined with the many partners' very practical experience for doing work on the ground and for making change happen. In many places, also frustration of being left alone, of needing more resources, of trying to find out where these resources could be found. And that in these same meetings was then oftentimes combined with somebody in another country who had solved a problem like that and who had actually mobilized resources to just address this. So what we could see is in the struggle for addressing the urgencies, sharing that same sense of urgency, quite immediately already during the meeting, not only a call for more action, but also the ability to inspire each other and learn from each other. Not surprising, the urgency fed very much by the continued challenge of making governance work, making water governance and management work, despite the major improvements that everybody had seen in implementing integrated water resource management practices, exacerbated by climate change, a sense for, in many places, that green water, the wetlands agenda, had perhaps been neglected in the past as an agenda for global water partnership teams to address and to take care of, something that came across in many places. A very strong sense for the Nexus agenda, for the cities agenda, for bringing people together who share the insight that meaningful action on water requires cross-sectoral action and where they could be found. Now, combined with that strong sense of urgency, there was a very much shared shared understanding that now is the time to mobilize further. The value of engaging citizen groups, of working also on awareness raising, whether this is through education or more communication campaigns. There were experiments, as many had pointed out, that are out there that can be shared across the network and thereby give rise to further ideas. Across the board, another topic that came out was the urgency of mobilizing youth and of giving youth the opportunity to participate in decision-making, to participate actively in decision-making and to be allowed into the decisions that shape the future, the decisions that ultimately make a difference for the younger people that have often finds and oftentimes in this sector in particular feel they're being left out. All of that obviously related with possibly shifting modes of engagement. There are needs for using different technologies for doing this, needs for bringing people in at different times of a process. But these are all questions that can be solved together and that also the strategy process can address. Finally, also across the room, where was a strong request for more and more active knowledge sharing across the network. Not so much top down, even though a number of regions actually said very concretely, we have this and that problem, we need this insight. We do want to solve something, we actually need a practical tool for that. And as these things came out, one of the pieces that we're finding for the strategy process is we can dig a little bit deeper in these very concrete questions for specific pieces of knowledge or pointing to specific gaps. But also we can start beginning mobilizing knowledge resources from across the network already in the year to come, 2019, even though that is still covered by our current and existing strategy. Now, what next? What are we going to do with all of this? Obviously, we're feeding it into the strategy process. But we're making sure it will influence and become part of the strategy. Alex, can you mute your mic? Secondly, there are things already happening and that can be further amplified. And again, as we are writing up the minutes of this, that will be possible. Thirdly, we will be able to communicate back to the partners that have been there. We will need to show the appreciation for the time that everybody has taken to influence that. And if only by making sure that we use the means that we had, the Facebook Live records, but also the graphic visualization activities around each of the sessions that can now feed back into steering committee conversations and into other discussions that we normally don't do as much in involving partners. Lastly, we need to recognize that we have, through this new way of engaging, also raised expectations. People have come into rooms, have shared their perspectives in which they normally aren't as much. I'm only recalling a room full of 40 partners in India, a room full of 20 partners in Bangladesh and Nepal. How the expectations that have been raised by these partners now, that how we would address those, this is something that we need to discuss in the executive team with our regional executive secretaries and regional chairs. But I could already see a lot of energy around amplifying that fabric of relationships that exist amongst partners in a country and that we're starting to build much stronger across countries. Finally, we have a powerful story. 26 hours that we have just seen here has not only demonstrated that, but have already given further energy to new stories that need to get out, that can be told. Being the voice of water, creating space for these voices to come out is one of the foremost roles for GWP and one that we will take on in the months to come, building on the richness, on the treasures that have been shared during the last 26 hours. Let me, in summarizing, thank everybody who has participated, thank the team in Stockholm, thank Monica, thank Eva, thank Stephen, thank Gil, thank the people who were the engines behind that, Martin, the untold stories on the technology side, thank the many communications officers in the regions who have brought people together for the preparation of this, have built energy leading up to this. But most of all, let me also thank our partners who have left us as a community that serves you, serves the partners, with their nuggets of insight, with their treasures of ideas and perspectives that we can together turn into meaningful action to improve how water is managed, how water is governed, so that we can all have a more meaningful life into the future. Thank you very much all around, and a big wave.
Thank you. We are finished.